Hello everyone, today I will teach you how to prepare MCQ quiz in Google Forms. Now before we start, the first thing you need to prepare one word file in which you are supposed to mention few details, for example name of the test, then brief description, means this description will be conveyed to the students when the students will see the MCQ test paper. Initially they will be able to see this part, so this is the instruction which you would like to give to the students. Then end description means after they have completed the test, what message you want to give to them, so this you can type it here. And page reference means this test might be belonging to some part of your textbook, so you can mention the page numbers for the reference of students. Now the best way is to write down all the questions along with the possible options. Here I have kept three options for each question and I have highlighted the correct option with yellow color. Okay, so suppose if I want to conduct the 10 marks MCQ test, then I will prepare 10 questions based on the subject matter, and I also am ready with the options and the correct answer. Now after this word file is ready, you need to open your Gmail account. In Gmail account, if you are able to see here, you will be able to see many Google applications. So here you are supposed to select Drive. Drive is the storage services by the Google. So whatever documents which you want to preserve for long period, you should save in Google Drive. So in Google Drive, you need to organize the things properly. For example, I have created one folder with the name Corona. Okay. Then I have created one folder with class 10th. Then I have created another folder for the subject economics, chapter number 1. Okay. So here, if you are able to see, one quiz form is already there. So I have already prepared this. Suppose if I want to create a new MCQ quiz, then here in this particular location where I want to save my quiz file, I will right click on the blank area. I will go to the option more, and here I am able to see Google Forms. Okay, and one arrow is there, then I will select the blank form. So as you can see, one blank form will get generated for me. Okay, so this is the blank form. Now what I am supposed to do? Okay, untitled form. So here, for example, you are already ready with your word file, so I will select this test name, control C, copy, and here I will do control V, paste. So this is done. Then form description, which instructions you want to share with the students. So here, first of all, I would like to give page reference to my students. So control C, here control V, and I also want to instruct my students. So whatever instruction is there, I will copy, and then here I will paste it. Okay. Now, first of all, I also need to ask the name of each and every student. So I will press this plus sign to add the question, and I will write the question, write your full name. Okay, but here I need short answer. So if it is MCQ, I need to select the short answer. So I have set the question, so I will be able to collect the student's name. Now to go on adding the MCQ question, I need to again press this add question plus sign. Okay, now here already MCQ choice is there, if not you can select, and you need to here type the question, but already we are ready with this word file. So I will copy the question here, I will paste it. Okay, now the most important step, first of all, okay, before we, let's say, go on starting with the questions or writing the options, we need to change the settings. So press on the settings. Then in the last we have the tab quizzes, select it, activate it so that it will be conducted as a quiz. Okay. Now, all these default options are proper. No need to change it. Then I will come to this general part. I will activate this collect email addresses so that the student's email ID will automatically get collected. Then response receipts. It means the students who has given this test should be able to get a copy or the assessed answer sheet. So I will activate this. I will tick always. Means in that particular email ID, student will get the answered paper. Acha, require sign in. No need to activate this. Okay. Here, if we activate this, then student will have to log in. So sometime it might be technical for the beginners. So right now, we are not activating this. Now, respondent scan. Edit after submit. It means if you tick this, then student will be able to edit their answer, since our intention is to see that they are able to learn. So we should allow them the edit option so that they can improve their scores, and also activate this so that they can see the response charts and summary. Okay. Then we have this presentation part. Okay. Now here we can activate show progress bar, and here shuffle the question order. If you want the questions to shuffle, then you should activate this. Now confirmation message. Now as I told you, in our word file and description, means after the test is given by the student, what message you would like to give them, already we have written here. So I will just copy and I will paste it here. Okay, then I will click save. So my settings are saved. These settings are very important. And now, already I had typed the question. I need to give options. And in this question number 1, I have 3 options. So, I will copy option number 1, paste it. Then second option, I will copy and paste. And then third option, I will copy and paste. Okay. But I know that second option is correct. So, I will press on this answer key. And I will select this option which is correct, and I will give the point or the marks as 1. Okay, since I want to conduct 10 marks MCQ, so I will give 1 marks. There are 10 such questions, so total 10 marks test is there, and I will press done. It means that this particular thing has been recorded. Another useful feature here is that key while answer key. Okay, if you want to, let's say, edit, so again I can press answer key, add answer feedback. Suppose you want to give some feedback to the students for incorrect answer. If you want to tell them why it is incorrect, or for the correct answer, why it is correct, you can write any of these comments so that student will be able to get your feedback. Okay. So like this, I need to go on copying the question from my word file and paste it here, and don't forget to give these points, and then press done. Okay, and you will be able to see here total points. Total point is 1. So I have typed only 1 question so far of MCQ. So similarly, if I type other 9 questions, then total 10 points will be there. So now your file is ready. Suppose if you want to, let's say, give reference, if you want to insert any video or let's say any image, then it is possible through these options. But initially I can suggest you practice this particular MCQ quiz format. Here the advantage will be there ki whatever responses student will submit in the same file, when you open, you are able to see responses. So you will be able to see whatever responses are there from this area. Now how to share with the students. Now there is an auto save function. No need to save. All changes are saved in the drive. Automatically it is saved for future. So now if I want to share, then I need to press send button. Okay. In the send, there are 2-3 options possible. Let's say first option. Okay. I will press this button. Okay. It is for link, and I will press shorten URL. So my bigger link will get shortened, and I will press copy. So it means this particular link has been copied. Then I will open this email. I will compose one email. Okay, and what I will do, I will email to myself this particular link. Okay, and in the subject, as I know already, I will use the same description so that you need not type it again and again. And in recipient, I am writing my own email ID. Okay. So, the advantage is that this particular quiz will get saved and you will be able to confirm from here. Another way, if you can open WhatsApp, okay, if you can open WhatsApp, and for that, this is the ID web.whatsapp.com, so that your WhatsApp will be available here, and directly you can share with the students or any of your WhatsApp contact. Okay, to activate this, you need to open WhatsApp in your mobile, and there are in the top right hand side corner near the search icon, there are three dots. By pressing that, you need to select WhatsApp web. So camera will start detecting QR code and then your WhatsApp will get activated. So this link, which is copied, can be shared directly in your WhatsApp contacts. But if your internet connection is slow, then you won't be able to share or you won't be able to run this WhatsApp. Okay, so luckily I'm able to, let's say right now, have access to my WhatsApp. Okay, so here if I want to share with, let's say, any particular person. So I will type the name. Link is already copied. And here I will press Ctrl V. Sorry, actually I need to again copy this link, and here I will paste it. Ctrl V. Hold for a few seconds so that it will catch some screen. It depends on the internet speed. Okay. Okay, so let me look here. So it has captured the theme of this particular item, and then I can press this button. So I am able to share through my email also. I am able to share through WhatsApp also. And if I, let's say, open this email, from the email I can copy and I can share this link as many times with any of the platform as per my requirements. So this link should be with me. Another advantage is that now there is no need to, let's say, keep this open. You can close it. It's an auto-saved function. So I will close it. Okay. Now look at the power, how it will work. I have shared this with myself. Okay. So assuming that I have also closed my Google Drive. So next time, if let's say somebody with this link presses on this link, then what will happen? This quiz will get opened. As I said, I am struggling with very slow internet connection. So you need to give it some time. Okay. So here it is already opened. Now write your email ID. Let's say I am writing my email ID. Okay. And let's say I have selected option number 1. I have written my name. Okay, and then submit. I actually forgot to delete this particular question. Okay, now sometime Google asks for verification. Select all the images with crosswalks. It's verified. Okay, so look here. So I was able to give this test, and if I press on view score, my score will get shown, and I have the option to see my previous response or edit my response or submit another response. Okay, since we have allowed the students to go for that, you can also deactivate. So look here, my score is 0 out of 1. Only one question was there and it was wrong. And the power is that here it will also suggest the correct answer. Okay, so by this way, student will be able to learn the concepts properly. Now let me tell you how you can see whether students are able to understand or how many students have actually gave this test. So again, from your Gmail, open Google Drive. Okay, remember the folder where you had created. So in 10th EQ chapter 1, I had created the new form. So this one is that particular form because I had not given the name. If I want to rename this file, then I can right click and I can rename it. Okay. Now, if I double click on this, then he look here. Just now I responded for this particular quiz and I will be able to see the response. Okay. So this type of data will also get generated. Okay. Name will also be there and you can also have Excel file for this particular responses. So I hope you are able to understand the process about how to create the quizzes. And the most important part is that suppose if you are saving properly folder wise in Google Drive, then you can retrieve this data at any point of time. And I would also suggest you to save your Word file also in this particular Google Drive. Now how you can save your Word file? It's very easy what you are supposed to do. Suppose I have created this Word file. Okay, so I just need to drag this file, okay, in this blank area so that in this particular folder my Word file will also get saved. So in future I can easily conduct and again resend this particular quiz. For any difficulty feel free to ask. Okay, bye.